We are many. Those that live beyond the veil of darkness, where nightmares are born. Sanity knows no bounds, and ends thrives on the suffering of the dead. Rot in the solace in the souls of the weak. We have taken refuge here among the mortals, in hope of a harvest for madnesses. Tread lightly in the search for the voices and stories of the departed, for in shadow hides the evil that lurks within. As the light dies and slowly becomes night, the realm of spirits rule the world. In the darkness of your mind hides your own hidden demons, and brings to life your deepest fear. Do you have what it takes to speak to the dead? Do you accept your own mortality in the search for life after life? Have you ever seen a ghost, spirit or demon? Have the lights flickered and the room became as cold as death itself? Maybe you have. Maybe it was your own subconscious preparing you for death. Come spend some of what's left of your own existence in our search for the answers that are hidden behind the veil. Shed off the blinders and open your mind's eye and listen to their stories. We are there. We are incarnate paranormal.
And what is up, everybody? How y'all doing? Give me a second here, I've got to adjust the screen. What a way to start off the stream with a sneeze, right, guys? Got some weird shit going on with my camera here. So just bear with me. There we go, we got it fixed. Sorry about that. Hope you guys are doing well tonight. It's Wednesday, one day closer to the weekend. Do apologize, there was no show last night. Got stuck at work. Shit happens. We got a lot of shows going out right now. So for the next couple of weeks, there might not be shows here and there, but I'm going to do the best I can to make sure we do either make up for them or do a weekend show or go extended when I can. Because we still got a lot to go, and it's probably going to take about 6 or 7 months to go through all this. And I'm sure you guys are okay with that. I know I am. Again, special thank you out to Susan and everybody at Nevada State Prison. Making this memorable. Cherie, Lingering Souls, Deads, Joe, everybody. Everybody at work is still asking about it. And, you know, me, I get long-winded. You guys know this. I'm happy to stop and talk about it. But, you know, I tell them, you want to watch it? I'd prefer you to do live on Twitch. You can always watch the VOD later on YouTube or on even on here. Each one of the shows, they're getting like 20 and 30 views. So I'm happy with that. Even TikTok. Links down below, by the way, guys. A couple of the videos have over 200 views after a day. So I'm going to start doing a lot of clips on here and putting them over up to there so people can see what we're doing. Try to draw an audience over there. And just thank you out to those guys who will be watching later on YouTube. And yeah, hope you guys are ready. We left off at the 20-minute mark on the first recorder. And this is 2 hours, 4 minutes. And like I said, the Zoom H1N recorders, for some reason, are breaking it up into files. So it's 2 hours, 2 hours, and like an hour and a half. or longer. I haven't checked. Actually, you know what? Let's check that real quick. While I got you guys here before we start, this is Sims Recorder. Night one. First one is 2 hours, 4 minutes. Second file is 2 hours, 4 minutes. And third file is 2 hours, 2 minutes. So six and a half hours. It broke up the files for night one. So and we're at 20 minutes. We got 6.5 hours. So we got at least 6 hours more of audio to go through. Hope you got your headphones on. Someplace comfortable to sit. Something nice and cold to drink or nice and warm depending where you're at because it was chilly today in Vegas. So let's get started, shall we? And pay attention because we don't have to deal with static this time. Turn up the soundboard just a hair. And I had the gain turned up on this, so. And I have amplified it quite a bit. That's why you gotta turn your volume up. Promise I won't hit the jump scare. We did not get this on the first two investigations. This constant knocking or banging. So I don't know what this is. It wasn't even windy on night one. It wasn't that windy, should I say. So we're going to be listening to this for a while. And I know, just part of it, it sucks. Like repetitive stress disorder, I swear to God. It almost looks like it's repetitive. Hold on. I don't know, that's, that could be an EVP. Let's bump this up, reverb. Sounds like it's saying turn it off. Mind you, there's nobody in the building right now. What's up, Chad? How you doing, buddy? Good to see you. So we're going to have to stop this. We're going to have to go a different route. We're going to have to go a completely different route on this one. Denoise. That didn't help too much. One more thing. If that doesn't work, we're going to have to skip it and kind of debunk it. So, I don't know. Maybe hit. No. Huh. Let's see. Capture noise point. This one's going to bother me. Let's see. Let's slow it down. See if that helps. This one's strange. It's not echo. It's definitely not echo because originally it was very low. And being I don't think there's anybody in the building. We're 22 minutes in. First setup. I think we're on our way over to culinary at this point. I don't completely remember. Okay, we're not going to be able to do it, just too much interference. So we got to debunk it. So how you doing tonight, Chad? How's everything over in the land of AV? Okay. There it is again. So we made the right call. We definitely made the right call debunking. So it's got to be an echo of some kind. Definitely not paranormal. And Tristan, how you doing tonight? Saw you snuck in. Do not understand all these doors shutting. See, this sounds like it's coming from the same room. That sounds like something's being dropped on a wood table. Another one of my teeth are fucked. I've been there. I feel for you. I hope it gets better soon. It's one of the worst things in the world. Can't sleep. Can't get comfortable. Can't eat right. Can't drink right. I hope you get it resolved fast. Every one of these sounds are repeating according to time. So I think it's either a residual sound or this is actually environmental. But it copies itself. The dentist said the wisdom tooth is almost split in half. Oh my God, that happened to me. Oh, let me pause this for a second. My wisdom tooth actually came in decayed and split. So I actually had to go in and have the oral maxillofacial surgery. They had to put me under, cut my gums to cut the tooth out. So I've been there, Matt. That is one of the worst feelings in the world. I feel for you. I really do. Find out where this one exploded while eating ribs. Oof. Happening in threes. Let me see something here. Yeah, it happens all the way through. It just matches all the way through the recording. Going to be strange. So I don't know if I anticipate much evidence on this recorder, but we do have 6.5 hours to go through. But I've been proven wrong before. I say we're not going to get anything, and lo and behold, dozen EVPs. Almost sounds like a fan blade. It sounds like an old fan spinning. Which would make perfect sense. This is an old fan. This might, because there was a slight breeze out, this might be the fan from the execution chamber when it was the gas chamber. This might be the ventilation fan to suck all the gas out. Actually, I think that's what it is. It's the only thing that makes sense. It's a whirling noise, so it's probably just a fan. And what's up, Sims? See you snuck in. How you doing tonight? Finally home from work, you're tired? I feel you. But I couldn't go 2 nights without a show. Work is overwhelming? I can relate. Prepping like 3 tours going out right now. So, I'm right there. I definitely need a weekend off. Thank you. There's an EVP. I think. At least it sounds like it. I could be wrong. I could be way wrong. It almost sounds like wake up. Let's go through and apply vocals one more time. Okay. Now we got to slow it down. This is just not working to our advantage tonight, is it? No, I don't know if I can call that an EVP. Okay. Now, let's try one more thing here. We're going to go there. All right. Okay. Let's see if this got it. What do you guys think? Yay, nay? I'm thinking no. But you guys can override me with unanimous vote. I'm saying no. Nah. Now, the weird thing is, sitting in the execution viewing room for an hour, we didn't hear these knocks. We didn't hear any of this. But the recorder's picking it up, which is strange. How is the recorder picking it up this loud and we're not hearing it ourselves? It One sounds like wood, and the other sounds like steel. Can't explain that. Definitely can't explain it. Okay, you can hear wind here. So this is probably wind hitting something outside, making it rattle. You can hear that. So there is a breeze outside. It wasn't windy, but it was breezy. So that would explain it's coming from what would be the east? Or I think the east. So if the wind's hitting that side of the building, it's probably hitting something loose up on the roof. And that's what's making the banging sounds. Debunk that. But what's coming from the inside is a different story. Like that. That's from inside the room. They're so much better than the Olympus recorders, ain't they? We don't have to. I'm going to say it 100 times. We do not have to fight freaking static distortion of any kind right now. Now, the ones we left in the cave are going to be a different story. I'm warning you guys. We're going to get a lot of echo. But they were inside the cave. A good at least 10 feet away from the gate. So we're not going to get a lot of interference, but what we do will be echo. And I even said before I went up for that this last trip, I was not going to set anything on a gate outside. There was too much interference. And I kept my end of the bargain on this one. The only downside, I was not able to put all the recorders where I say I was going to. So I tried to split them up the best I could because I wanted to do things we hadn't done before. For a second, guys. Can I do this real quick? Come on. Sorry about that, guys. I take care of something real quick. Take care of something real quick. Whoa. There's a voice. What do you guys think? Sounds like it's saying a name, doesn't it? I don't know why it would say the name like that because he doesn't like his name said like that. At least that's what I'm hearing, so. Okay, let's slow this down. I'm pretty sure I know what this was saying. And it's hidden in between the clanks. So. It is. I'm 99% sure this is actually saying Carol Cole. Now, we all know, and I've said this, he hated being called Carol Cole. It was Edward Cole or Ed Cole, or I was calling him during the investigation. I was calling him Eddie. Hey, you're my friend now. I've been here 3 times to speak to you. I hope you don't mind that I'm going to call you Eddie. So I'm hearing Carol Cole on this one, and I think we're going to save it as this. So yeah, we're going to save this as Carol Cole. Yeah. Carol Cole. Wow. We got it. And guys, I'm going to be clipping a lot. Basically for TikTok. So every time you see one, a good piece of evidence, I'm going to clip it and upload it later. So let's get this saved. So where are we at? We're at number 4. Alright, so that's EVP4, Sims Recorder, Execution Viewing Room, Night 1, Carol Cole. And that is 2249. What's up, Deads? How you doing, buddy? Yeah. Did you hear this EVP or did you just get here? So I'll give you a second and I'll replay it a couple more times. I can't. I just, this is good EVP, not great, but no, I'll take it. Not bad, Carol Cole. we know it's not him, like I just said, but we got a name coming out. We got a name. So, question is, who's saying it? Moving along. Yeah, what the hell is right? Right in between the bangs. And it sounds angry. Whoever it is mad. Not once did I say Carol Cole during that investigation. So, they might have remembered me from last time. And it was a little breezy the first night, wasn't it? It wasn't windy, but it was breezy. So all these bangs, I'm pretty damn sure, are coming from the roof. Minus the ones inside. Whoa, what the... We haven't gotten three like that before. Okay, so we, a lot of that's going to be explainable. And there it is again, the three knocks, but a lot lighter. So this has got to be the wind. That's got... This does not sound like from outside, though. It's too strong. That cannot be wind. Like I said, we're 35 minutes in. We're not even in this building anymore. It's almost like a rapping on the bars. It's... Sounds like somebody's beating on something. But I don't know anymore. Trying not to count knocking sounds. Unless we're asking for it. If we're doing the bump, 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 waiting for that dun, dun, then I'll count it. But beyond that, I don't think I'm, unless it's something extraordinary, I don't think we're counting it. Could be a residual of one of the inmates beating the other to death. Because it's in last night's cells, I doubt it. Unless that residual is traveling, I don't think so. I'm not going to say no, but... it's probably completely explainable. Oh, sound does travel. Huge. We heard it the other night when we were all the way freaking up in... we were up in, what, C or D? No, we were down in the law library, and sound traveled from the recorders. So, yeah, it's... sound travel's pretty damn good. Here's the one, the voices could jump out at any possible time. And it's just odd we did not spend a lot of time up in this area. Our second car. I'm surprised we haven't picked up that many vehicles. But then again, it's only like we're 40 minutes in, so it's about maybe a quarter after 5, which would be going into rush hour, so we're not getting a lot of traffic to debunk. And I'm happy with that. I don't even think we heard a lot of traffic while we were there. Kind of surprising. What I think is going to be extraordinarily funny is if the prison, the active prison, takes over the active pods again and somebody gets stuck in Neil Pitney's cell. It's going to be freaking great. Half these cells are haunted and people are going to be screaming all night long, "Let me out, there's ghosts trying to get me." And then they get a psych evaluation. not realizing the history of these cells. Oh, it's going to be epic. But like I said, I don't see it happening. Too much money involved. Or Joseph writes, yep. See these guys just clawing on the doors to get out. It'd be like, yep. If I was a prison guard, I'd be like, there's ghosts in there, but we can't admit it. We're just going to watch them on camera going crazy. The fuck? Oh, yeah, the pictures. That's something dragging. Just so you see, Dez and I talking about pictures, guys. We got to see a lot of the pictures taken from the prison. By the prison guards, from some of the crimes that were committed behind prison walls, attacks, so on and so forth. We are not allowed to share those for obvious reasons. They show a lot of blood and a lot of disturbing images. For some of these crimes, and the manner and they were in what they were committed, it's almost obvious that there's going to be some anger there, some fright, some terror, all the emotions you could think possible, and it's going to be trapped in these areas. And seeing these pictures, it is almost most definite that these areas are going to be paranormally active. I'm trying to be careful of what I say to protect all parties involved. They involve death. They involve assaults by people that survived and other. But they're very disturbing images. Very disturbing images. But this is life behind prison with violent inmates. And this is what happens when the wrong inmates get the information on said people that were attacked. So this is when you see talking about the pictures, this is what we're talking about. And this helps us use for the investigations. It helps us get an idea of what we want to ask, how we want to ask it, and try to respect the memory of what spirits might be there after seeing said evidence. I hope that was not all over the place for you guys, but it's about as professional as I can put it. So, that being said, moving along. I don't know. That's debunk. That sounds like something dropping on wood, though. Not on steel or concrete, but that sounds like a wood echo. And the only thing wood that I know of in that area is the table where our recorders are set. hell? Why does that sound like the string of a banjo? That's got to be some type of metal outside. Is that, I swear to God, that sounds like a wire being strung. Or a wire being strum, should I say. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, that's not a banjo. That's for sure. But definitely a wire being plucked. Just echo. God, a lot of echo. What? Sorry about that. Little windows pop up for some dumb reason. I'm most upset on this, so we're only 48 minutes into the first recorder, and we've got four EVPs, but I guess that's not too bad. That's pretty much one every 10 minutes. A lot better than our average on others, ain't it? I bitch about not getting EVPs, and lo and behold, what happens? Now, all right. I know exactly what that says. This is a good one, and I'm pretty sure I know who that EVP is. Now, it's, unless they give you a name, I mean a definite name, and you remember the voice, you're not going to be able to put a name to the EVP. Now, this investigation, I think, is going to be a lot different. Meaning, the spirits knew I was coming back, and they were active minute one walking in the door. So, we might be able to put names or voices to names or names to voices. This one, I'm fairly sure I can identify. Now, what do you guys think? Then I'll tell you what and who it is. So, before I save this, this is, I'm 90% sure on this one, this is Get Me Home, and this is an EVP of Floyd Burton Loveless, 17-year-old sent to the gas chamber, the boy Nevada killed. The reason I say that is he was worried that his family would not have the money to send his body home. Now, if I remember the price correctly, in 1948, when his body was shipped home from Nevada, it's not get, are you sure? Take me home or get me home. Let's amplify this. Take me home. Okay. I hear both, so. Okay, we're gonna clip this again. So, take me home. So even if it is take me home, I still think this is Floyd Burton Loveless. As I was saying, to have his body shipped home from Nevada back east in 1948 cost like $17 to have his body shipped by train. I feel, what's going on, Vexus? How you doing? Good to see you. Thank you for being here. Deds, if you want a good book, The Boy Nevada Killed. And you won't feel sorry for him so much, but you will almost, I don't want to say pity him, but you will have a little bit of, you'll understand why Nevada did it, but on the other side, why do it to a child? Or a young man. Let's not call him a child. He was 17. So, yeah, but he was younger than that when he committed the crime. That's what I was reading on the plane, yes. It is an amazing book. And I'll say there's a lot of bad reviews on it saying it's too biased. It's not biased at all. It's taken from every legal standpoint possible. So let's get this saved and move along. And that's all actually Floyd wanted is to go home to his family. And that's what he said right up until his death. I just want to go home. And unfortunately, with all his appeals, the courts just wouldn't have it. Tragic story, it really is. His life was, just the way he grew up and what happened in his surroundings, you understand why he went down the path he did, and it went too far. So, but the crimes that he was not tried for, the crimes he was not locked up for before the murder, would have kept him out of the death chamber had they convicted him, and he would have just done time in jail and been out. But it is what it is, guys. You can't save them all, but you got to feel for some of them. So Take Me Home is pretty damn good EVP. At first, it did sound like Get Me Home, though, but Take Me Home, Get Me Home, same principle. Wait a minute. While your COVID ass falls asleep, you got... Man, sorry to hear you got COVID. That's Echo. Katrina Weedman. Honestly, don't even know who that is. Oh, Portals to Hell. Paranormal Lockdown. Work with Nick Groff. Yeah, you know my thoughts on the paranormal shows. Not saying she's not a legit investigator. But as I always said, remember, they're actors first. You want her to be different or just in your bed? I'm not going to say yes, I'm not going to say no, but I agree. I'd rather have Chelsea from Destination Fear, so. And I can't believe I just said that on air to where there's a record of it. I honestly think, though, I don't know Vexus very well, but I can almost, I don't want to say guaranteed, almost assure, as soon as that meter went off on our final night, when I started asking those questions after going through, which everybody will see toward the end of the evidence, that, yeah, he probably would have freaked out a little bit. I know, because I kept my cool, but inside I was... like, oh shit, what's going on here? What? They're all lighting it up. They're all doing what we ask. It's like, okay, you're waiting for something to walk up and tap you on the shoulder. Or the don't go. The don't go the first night. That was intense. Nothing. See, and I'll give this away because where were we when that happened, Duds? Were we up in we were up in 12 when it said don't go, wasn't it? I think we were up in 12. I don't freaking completely remember. But to be walking out of a building and actually hear don't go that loud. And it's like you look at each other, it's like, did they just say that? Yeah, they did. It's like, we'll be back later. We got to get gear set up. You know, we can't stop in the middle of setup just to talk to you. But that's going to be a spoiler. I don't remember where it was at, but we will get to the recorder, and I hope to God the GoPro or the recorder picked it up. You know, I really hope that starting off on TikTok is going to bring some viewers into here. The amount of likes and views the videos are getting right now, I wish I could get that on here. I wish I could hit the 243, you know, views on here for a video. I think that'd be cool as shit. To see 243 pop up in the top left corner. Be like, yeah, this is gonna be fun. But hold on. That's different. That's internal. That's not outside. Sounds like a normal door, a normal metal door being shut. Oh, can't call it paranormal though. Yeah, I had somebody finally talk me into it. Brent, you gotta do it. As much as you hate TikTok, you have to set it up. But in the long run, it's going to help us. But I love my small community. I really do. What? I'm hearing die in here. This is a whisper, but it's definitely a word. It's definitely two words. Okay, that's... Push it up twice on each one so we get it'll be easier to clean up. Okay. Bring that down so we don't go deaf. Thank you. definitely hearing die in here. Die something. If we're gonna get die tonight, I'm gonna be happy. That's gonna be a good note. You guys hear die on this one at all? Because I swear I'm hearing die. And I'm sorry I had the mic muted. We are going to save that one. We can always go back and delete it. Let's keep going. What we are getting is like whispers. Makes me think it's coming from the other room. But night one, unfortunately, The recorder turned itself off. So we're going to get nothing from execution viewing night one except for Dead's GoPro. The ghosts are knocking, but they can't come in. Officially the stupidest thing I've ever said. On stream. Echo. Debunk. I don't even want to hit the button. I've used it so much tonight. Just think, guys, we got 6 hours of knocking. 6 hours of this weird-ass sounds. definitely getting more traffic than spirits, but like I said, hour one of about 270. You figure, let's see, what did I say? Figure 7 hours. 7 times 15, 95 times. What did I say? Wait, let's do the math here, guys. 7 record, or we have figure 15 recorders times 7 hours each. Hundred and fifteen hours of audio we have to go through. At least 315 hours minimum audio. Oh my God. Plus yours, so figure, I said 315 plus another 4 times 7, 28, 56, 72, another, let's just figure 300 hours of audio. Let's just be honest about this, about 300 hours of audio plus video. We got a long way to go, guys. We got a long way to freaking go. 35 hours each day, so like I said, about 300 hours of audio. Heard a little whimper on my side. These are the interesting parts about being a paranormal investigator. You don't think closer to 400. Why you gotta break my spirits, man? Why you gotta break my spirits? These are the pains of being a paranormal investigator. And I'm going to pause this for a second. Usually you go into a location, you don't set up recorders in every possible room in a location with a million square feet. You just don't do it. Or most investigators don't do it. Let's put it that way. 95 to 97% of investigators will not do it. They'll set up static cameras somewhere. They'll set up trail cams somewhere. Because it's so easy to go through. You just hit play and you sit back and watch. It's like watching a movie for hours on end. Audio? Nobody just puts up recorders spread out like this. And this is what kind of impresses the prison about Susan and them at the prison. We sit down and talk to the spirits like they're people, and we cover every square inch possible. And that's what I love to do, because not every building's going to be active. Not every building has, potential to be active. Spirits travel, just like we go to work every day. Do they go from building to building? Entirely possible. Next time you bring self trail cams, I'm thinking about it. Actually, a guy at work said that to me today, said it yesterday. Brent, take trail cams. Make it easier. I've got two of them. Problem is, they take like 8 AA's, and that's going to add to my battery bill. But I might get some rechargeable ones, because I know Cabela's has them on sale for like $60 each right now. But nobody sets up like we do. I mean, Cisbro Paranormal had two cameras set up last year. Forget which paranormal team, the deaf paranormal team we had join us. They had a couple set up. But you don't go to every building. The time involved to cover all this is astronomical, especially in a 3-day span. We could have spent a week in Nevada State Prison and not thoroughly covered every building. I mean, and actually, truly investigate it. Even if you spend 2 hours in each building, you figure there's two, there's what, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Even if you spent 2 hours in each building, that's 16 hours. You're only investigating 7 hours, 6 to 7 hours a night. So you're not going to even cover, you're going to cover about half the buildings. To do it right, you need 3 or 4 hours in each building. I might have to see if Susan do 4 days next year. I don't know, guys. We're going to figure something out even better, because next year, hopefully, we're going to have more gear, more people, and more for the show. But the more we get, the more we analyze, and the longer it's going to take to analyze, we're going to be at, you know, Nevada State Prison episode 472. You know, we're going to have more shows than EVPs to analyze one investigation of the prison. I ain't got a problem with that. There's a rice rocket. Might have another. Let's see what we can get into. Let's see what we can do tonight. Okay, I'm gonna have to. I do this a couple times on each. I'm hearing something, just not 100% sure what. We got to be positive on these. Even if we have to spend 20 or 30 minutes on one EVP, just to make sure we can get the prison the best that we can. Thank you. Whew, starting to bother my eyes a little bit, guys. What do you guys think? Is this ambient noise or is this an EVP? Well, one's the wind. Yeah, there's an alternating pitch. You're 100% right. It sounds like it says, cheat me. I want to get rid of that warbling. Believe me, Dad, so am I. So am I, buddy. How do you get rid of the warbling? Gonna drive me crazy. We've got to get this one. Okay, let's try this. Shit. I don't know. I don't know what else to try. I don't want to lose this. If it is an EVP, I know it's not going to be the only one we lose through the investigation. There's only one other thing I could think of trying. And if this doesn't get it, we're going to debunk it. I'm not even hearing that, Deds. You're hearing something I'm not. So, unfortunately, guys, I'm going to. I can't hear enough on my side to even guess. What I'm hearing is this. Which I, it's rough, so. Unfortunately, guys, this is one of the ones we're going to lose. It's part of the field. And it sucks when you have to lose possible evidence, but it is, I've always said, it's better to lose the EVP than present to your client something that's possibly not there. So I'm okay. We're on recorder one. An hour into 400. So we're at like 0.25%. And we can lose a couple. We're okay with it. We're 6 EVPs in. I mean, we're definitely going to beat the last investigation as far as I hope. Now, if we don't beat it, yes, it'll be disappointing, but it's okay. Like I said, if it goes the way it should, we should hit about 600. So we spent about 10 minutes on that one EVP. We've done worse. That sounds like a train. Tell me, does that not sound like a train horn? That sounds like one of those steam horns. It's not, but it sounds like it. Not paranormal, but a unique sound. I'm honestly curious how many groups out there would actually consider all these knocks paranormal. These are the spirits knocking to let us know they're here. No. Sorry guys, allergies are acting up. tonight. We're approaching the 2-hour mark, about right where I want to be, or try to gun for every show. Probably not going to happen every show. We know this, but it's part of it. We actually got 3 EVPs tonight. Well, we got 3 the first show, 3 now. Run through them real quick. We got Burning Me or Hurting Me. We couldn't decide which. Sleep Bad, Prick, an insult. Tonight we got Carol Cole, Take Me Home, and Die. So we got some pretty substantial EVPs, not earth-shattering, but they were good. Again, everybody, Deads, Vexus, Tristan, and everybody else who's tuning in, make sure, hit that like, hit me up on all the socials. I will be adding highlight clips to TikTok. And, yeah, we're going to do our best to be here almost every night, minus Saturday, Sunday. Unless I work late during the week, then I'll try to make up on the weekend. We're having fun with this, and we're just scratching the surface. You guys have a great night. God bless, and I'll see y'all tomorrow night. Thank you for being here, and y'all take care.
Would you shut the fuck up?